Good evening. Well, all those little aspen shoots that pop up in your lawn, I let mine grow because I don't call them aspen shoots. I call them goat food. And I let them grow for about 2 years and then I cut them down. And in the fall, my goats have something to rub their horns on, like little Hobbs is doing there. Charlie taught him how to do that. Get a branch between your horns and rub. It's an activity that I can have my kids on one side, my weathers and mamas on the other, so everybody's safe, but they can share in the same activity with the tree. It's kind of super fun eating, super different, but also they can play and interact with it. And it's free, right? It just grows in your lawn. I think this is, Charlie takes great pleasure in trees, but she mostly loves to rub herself, chew the bark. She teaches the kids how to get their horns going. Sharpen your horns, Hobbs, sharpen your horns. They like to get the branch between the horns and just scratch that tween spot. That's their favorite spot. Hobbs, you're going to town, man. Anytime Charlie does something and it's, oh, there goes Moonshine. She's doing it too. Anytime Charlie does something, they mimic her, and she is my queen. Hello, and Sunny wants to be milked. She's getting full. She's got another hour before I milk her. But there's something about Charlie. I mean, she is my queen, so they're going to follow her lead. But she's also super playful, and she teaches the kids skills and games. She was in heat 3 days ago. And my two baby now weathers, who were bucklings just 2 weeks ago, boy, did they take great pleasure in her being in heat. And they were like her little minions for an entire day, mounting and rubbing on her and being little bucks, even though they're weathers now. And their banded testicles are doing really well. They're super, super small. And you can tell the tissue inside is dead and now it's just waiting for them to fall off. So I would imagine these guys, it's going to fall off in 2 weeks instead of four because it happened rather quickly. Oh, there goes Easy rubbing his horns. His horns are so beautiful. And they're just now starting to turn out and twist. But he's got gigantic horns and they're just growing, growing. Almost, you can see him growing weekly. Easy. Why'd you do that to your mama? You got high centered on your mama's back. Let's see what he does. Well, who's there? Well, hi, Miss Tangle. Tangle's been so... Tangle was the one kid who I had such mixed feelings about. She wanted to be near me, but she was really like over the top, like jumping on me and pouncing and always in my space. And it was just a little bit too much. And now that she's 14 weeks old, oh my gosh, she just came with a lot of zazz, I think. She is so affectionate and she is so yummy and she wants to be doing whatever I'm doing. And she wants to be really, really close to me. And so it's, you know, maturity counts for something. And look at her hippie hair on her back. You can see her long, right here, look how long that is. She's got beautiful hippie hair. You got hippie hair. There he goes. See, they love to just like get into trees and scratch and interact and... It's a whole thing. It's not just food, right? It's the acquisition of food. It's the interacting with the environment. Easy's, yeah, he's been kind of a jerk to Sunny lately. I've got to watch that. And I think it's because his mom was in heat. It kind of got everyone riled up. Usually Charlie and Sunny come into heat one day apart. Sunny has not come into heat yet. She's still in milk, so I don't know if that's like pushing her back. But they're almost always in heat at the same time. This time they didn't, though. Easy, you're getting crazy. You're getting crazy. Yeah, look at that. Oh, Tangle. Oh, Tangle. There's your tween spot. There's your tween spot between your horns. They love that most of all. Just getting that rubbed. Oh, that feels so good. And she's my delicate female. Well, she's not delicate. She's kind of pretty hardcore, but she's got this long, delicate neck, just like a deer. Like, her neck is phenomenally long. And she's just really elegant looking. And she's got kind of a gray-brown face. We call it Bray. And she's starting to get white flashing on her sides like her mom. Sunny, who's next to her, is her mom. And Moonshine, who's my little bruiser, she's starting to mellow out as well. And Carlos, your face is so dirty from all the dust on that tree, dude. Carlos, we call him Peace Out. Anytime there's conflict, he walks away from it, and it's like he's throwing down and going, Peace Out. He wants nothing to do with conflict. He is such my surfer dude, chill weather. I think he would have made a phenomenal buck, and my only problem with that is I wouldn't have used him with my own girls because they would have all been related. And, but he has the nicest temperament. I mean, if I could have an entire herd of surfer dude goats like this, he is fearless. He'll go for walks with me. He follows me around. He doesn't want conflict. He gets along with all the goats. Even the adult goats kind of like him, except for Sunny. Sunny's his mom, and Sunny still has issues with him since she booted him. Not quite sure what conflict they had at 2 days of age, but they did. You can see his little teeth. Those are your little teeth. And his horns are going to be huge as well. You eating my zipper? Okay, I'm going to let these guys play. I'm going to go do chores. Yeah, let's go do chores. Well, hello. Hi, Tangle. Hello, Jezebel. We're in the high 60s, low 70s during the day and 30s at night. Hi, guys. Hello. Hello. Hi, Hobnob. Hi, Carlos. Moonshine. Hey, there you are. And see, Tangle's getting super jumpy right now. Massimo! There you are. Hello. Hi, Mama Beats. And they'll actually walk away from a tree and follow me now, which is kind of nice. And all five kids are on a bottle now because I'm weaning Moonshine and Tangle from Sunny. And now she is just in milk for us. And I'm bottle feeding these guys. I think I said in an earlier video, I just don't, like, I know it's expensive and I know it's kind of a pain in the ass to continue to bottle feed. Like, it is time consuming. But the health benefits emotionally, socially, for trust, for gut health, it just makes sense to continue while they're developing. And in the wild, goats will wean right between 5 and 6 months. I know my wethers last year did not wean until almost seven and a half months. And I should have called that a little bit sooner, only because they were so big at that age and their horns were so big that I'm gonna venture to guess that the twins' horns, when they went underneath to popper to get the milk to let down in the udders, that they did damage that one side because Charlie's udders did not come in the same this year. And it was just too long. But I think in a pasture setting where the mom can't like walk away, like she can walk across the pasture, but they can track her down. But if they were in the wild going through the forest and the mountains and she kept walking, they wouldn't be able to kind of pin her down and force nurse, you know? So these guys are 14 weeks old. They still are getting 2 bottles a day. I'm decreasing 1 ounce every couple days. And they're doing pretty good with that. And they're eating more hay, a little more alfalfa pellets, boss, which is black oil sunflower seeds. And then I have free choice kelp and kelp with herbs for them. Here comes moonshine. I put the electric spools out here yesterday and they've been having so much fun. Actually, Hobbs did turf off. Jezebel, was it you who pushed your brother off? She goes, yeah, what about that? I think she knocked Hobbs off yesterday. And so he didn't seem to be hurt by it, but anytime I put new stuff out or rearrange their play yard, it becomes like a new novel thing. It's super fun. Hello, Moonshine. I know you like doing your parkour off there. She does fantastic aerials sometimes. Hi, Hobnob. You look so pretty in the fall sunlight. Mm-hmm. Ooh, be careful. Yes, you're such a good boy. Hi, Moonshine. Hello. 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 Yeah. There you go. Oh my gosh. So can you see the colors? Getting super, super beautiful. Jezebel, why are you nibbling on me, honey? You nibbling on me. And she's been super sweet. All of them have been super sweetie. And it probably is time for some new electric spools. These are from 2019. We got these in the spring of 2019 and they've been outside the whole time and I'm pretty sure that the wood is starting to rot. Fairly certain of it because they're starting to look bowed and they sound creaky. I love when they get on their new equipment. Okay guys, I have to go finish chores. These chores, you can't come with me. It's in the garden. And I know what you would do with my garden. I know. Tangle, why are you so jumpy? Why? Oh, Carlitos. Hi. Let's get Carlos. I don't want you to jump. Don't want you to jump. Okay, I'm going to finish chores. Okay, guys, I have to go work. You guys can do whatever you want. Hobbs, don't let your sisters beat you up. I know it's hard keeping track of them, isn't it? Such a great group of kids. Cannot tell you how stoked I am with their temperaments, with their size, with their health. Everything. These are the goats I dreamed of. And we are starting to, even though it's 2022, I am just now starting to line up a buck for next fall because these three girls, so Tangle, Jezebel, Moonshine is black and white. Those three I will breed in 2023 in the fall. And so I'm looking for a naturally reared alpine buck. And so they'll be 3/4 alpine, 1/4 Nubian. I'm super stoked about that mix. And then my wethers will be, the Carlos and Hobbs will for sure be big enough to join Easy and Absinthe out on the trail. And that'll be super, super fun. I'd like to get the girls out on the trail this whole next year before I start breeding them. Once I breed them, it seems kind of hard for them, especially like Sunny, because she's all Nubian, and Nubians are just big. Well, she's a big girl, so some are bigger than others. Oh, Tangle and Massimo. Massimo has a thing with the goats. Look at, see how he's got his head cocked? He'll do that. He'll pretend he's hiding behind a post. What are you doing, Moss? Good boy. See, he'll go right behind a post. Look, oh, you can't see me. Massimo and Charlie had a thing first, and now the kids are becoming really familiar with Massimo. But I would like to get these guys out on trails for the next year because they're so young. They really, really, really want to be with me. And I think this would be a great year to just kind of acclimate them to the trailer travel and collars and leashes. And for sure, for the first year, they wouldn't have any saddle or weight. It would just be getting them used to being on a trail with me. Good boy, Carlos. Good boy, Massimo. Good boy. Carlos, your tail's wagging. And it's really interesting. These two have really similar temperament. But see how Carlos doesn't run away? Good boy, Massimo. Good boy. Look how dirty your face is from the aspen tree. Yeah. He is going to be a giant. That boy's frame is just huge. Good girl, Beats. Okay, time to get into the garden.